We call someone or something who dresses alike or sounds alike. Twinsie. A twinsie is anything or anyone who are alike enough to be a twin, even though we know they are not. Maybe you and a friend say the exact same thing at the same time. Twinsie. Two dogs that are walking at the park that are the same breed. Twinsie. This video is from the Twinsie series from Better with Bacon. Each video is one story from the Old Testament in the Bible that is Twinsie, with a story from the New Testament. Make sure you check out the other fun videos of this series. If you like this video, click like, or better yet, subscribe. Elijah was a prophet of God. That means God would sometimes talk to Elijah. Usually what God talked to him about was what God needed Elijah to say or do. Sometimes though God would only give him a part of what was to happen. It was up to Elijah to believe and obey God. This is what happened one day. God told Elijah that he was to go to a certain town. There was a woman there that he was to help. But God didn't say who. However, he was righteous and trusted God, so he went. When he arrived at the town, he waited for the Lord to tell him what to do next. He kept waiting. It was hot, and he was thirsty. He saw a woman and he asked her if she would bring him some water. The woman was kind, so she went to bring the prophet some water. His stomach growled. When she brought him water, Elijah asked her if she also had something that he could eat, because he was hungry from his trip. When Elijah asked her this, she turned to him very sad and mournful. With tears in her eyes, she said, "I have no bread to share with you, sir. I only have a little oil and a little flour at my poor home. I was going to make one small biscuit from it, so that my son and I could have a last meal before we starve. My husband died and we have no money." Elijah then knew. This was the woman God had told Elijah to find in this town. "Do not be afraid," the prophet said. "Do not be sad. For the Lord has heard your cries, and knows your distress. Come, take me to your house and we will eat." The widow took Elijah to her house. She began to pour oil from a jar and flour from a jar to bake bread. Funny, she didn't remember having this much oil and flour. Every time she poured more oil and flour out from her jars, the same amount stayed in the jars. They never emptied, no matter how much she used. She and her son were saved by God. I wonder if they opened a bakery to sell all the things she could now bake. Twinsie. This story from the Old Testament of the Bible is Twinsie with a story from the New Testament. It is the story of Jesus and his first miracle. When Jesus turned 30 years old, he knew it was time for him to begin his ministry of sharing the love of God, and to tell people about how God wanted them to live. This is why Jesus came from heaven to earth. Jesus began to call some people to follow him and to learn from him. They would be his disciples, which is another word for student, because Jesus knew that he would only be here for a short time. Early in his ministry, Jesus and his disciples were invited to a wedding, so they went to the nearby land of Cana to attend. His family, including his mother Mary, was also there for the wedding. Weddings at this time and place were big events, the biggest event in a groom or bride's whole life. Their wedding was a huge celebration. A lot of eating, drinking, dancing, and singing. The wedding was going wonderfully. But then the wine ran out after a couple of days. The workers at the party started mumbling. What were they going to do? Jesus' mother, Mary, overheard them. She felt sorry for the bride and groom. They would be so ashamed and embarrassed. Mary didn't know how she could help, but she knew that her son Jesus could. She ran to tell him what was happening. After she told Jesus, she ran to the workers at the wedding party. "Do whatever my son tells you to do." They agreed, because they didn't know what else to do. In the wedding hall, there were 6 large empty jars. Jesus told the servants to fill up the jars with water. They filled the 6 jars, all the way to the top. Then Jesus told them to draw out some and take it to their boss. The steward couldn't believe that there was wine again for the wedding party. Not only that, It was the best wine he had ever tasted. How did the bride and groom get this wine? This was the first time Jesus used the power that God his Father had given him. It was his first miracle. It foreshadowed the Last Supper with Holy Communion. Twinsie!